سلم على اسمك ايش؟ عندهم صور دار ور فيو مسلم زين. And he said to his people, Abu Sufyan, because the Muslims were confused now. Abu Sufyan said that he called, where is the Prophet Muhammad? The Prophet did not answer. In the battlefield. He said, where is Abu Bakr? No answer. The Prophet said, don't answer. So he said, where is Umar? Umar, the Prophet said, don't answer. Then afterwards, Umar became very angry. And he said, no, Allah had made the Prophet and Abu Bakr and Umar alive. Umar, she shouted. He said there are lots. So afterwards, the Muslims were, they lost 70 people. One of them is the great command, great companion of the uncle of the Prophet, Hamza ibn Abi Talib. He was martyred there. He is Sayyid al-Shuhada. He is the master of the martyrs. Sayyid al-Shuhada. He was martyred. And also, many great companions of the Prophet, like the first ambassador of Islam, Mus'ab ibn Umair. Because he was sent as the first ambassador from Mecca to Medina to teach them about Islam. And many companions of the Prophet afterwards from Ansar, supporters, they became because of Allah and afterwards because of the Prophet Muhammad. Now afterwards, the Prophet ﷺ rearranged his people, his companions, and afterwards, alhamdulillah, the Muslims became victorious. But they lost many of their 70 of the great companions of Allah. And even after that, the disbelievers, the Meccans, retreated. After they felt that they have revenge. Revenge. And they have retaliated for what they have done. Because during the Battle of Badr, the Muslims killed so many from the disbelievers. They said, now this is a retaliation. So they felt they are satisfied, so they tried to retreat, going to Mecca. But the Prophet ﷺ said, no, we will follow them. To show that the Muslims, although they were wounded, and they had many casualties, but they still strong. And the Prophet ﷺ followed them until to a certain point, then they left, and the Prophet ﷺ came back to Medina. And during this battle, the Battle of Uhud, before the start of the battle, the Prophet ﷺ had like full quota. Many companions. But while he was, before he leave Medina to come to here, he wanted to consult with his companions. He said, do you want to come here or you want to stay in Medina? Some of them, the young people, they said, we want to go out. And some of them, they said, no, let's stay in Medina. Because this is considered like outside of the borders of Medina. Medina is like the area of Masjid at that time. So the Prophet ﷺ came here, and there was one munafiq, Abdullah ibn Ubay. Abdullah ibn Ubay, munafiq, he's a hypocrite. He convinced like one third of the army of the Prophet ﷺ to go back. Because the Prophet did not listen to his invitation, Abdullah ibn Ubay. He wanted the Prophet to stay in Medina. But the Prophet ﷺ is young. Muslims, they said, let's go out. So that munafiq, he put like one third of the Sahaba. So alhamdulillah, afterwards anyway, many of the Sahaba were martyred here, you will see their place there. The place of the Sahaba martyred. Hamza ibn Abi Talib and the others. Al Mus'ab ibn Umair. Thank you. جبل فرادايس جبل الجنة. This is from paradise.
This one?
Yes, جبل. This is a part of it. One day the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and Abu Bakr and Umar and Uthman were above the on the mount. Above. So this mountain shake. The Prophet said, "Still down, settle down." Only a prophet above you, Prophet Muhammad, and Siddiq, Abu Bakr, Siddiq, and two martyrs, Umar and Uthman, they were killed, you remember. So the Prophet said to the mountain, settle down, there is above you the Prophet and the Siddiq, Abu Bakr, and two martyrs, Abu Bakr, Uthman and Umar. May Allah be
pleased. Sheikh, there was a flood in some season and some of the grave for
yes
change.
After this some years, tens of years afterward, there came a flood here in Medina and it uncovered some of the graves here. So the people during that time, they wanted to remove the martyrs from one place to another, so they will have solid land, strong land, so they will cover them. They came to Abdullah ibn Haram. He was the father of Jabir ibn Abdullah, companion of the Prophet. He was murdered during this battle. So they wanted to remove him. They saw him as if he is dead today.
Yes.
He's fresh. Fresh. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Holy Quran that the murdered for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the earth that does not eat their bodies. They are alive. But not like our life. Special life. Special. And they are
enjoying
it.
Huh?
Yes. Hamza. Here is Hamza. He is the uncle of the Prophet. When he was murdered,
there?
A woman, Hind bint Utba, she was from Meccans. Hamza killed her father and her brothers. Hind bint Utba, yeah. He killed some of her relatives, very close relatives. She did, she said, anybody kills Hamza, I'll give him a reward. And the one who killed Hamza was Habashi. Was a dark slave from Habashi, from Abyssinia. He managed to kill Hamza. Because Hamza was the lion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He killed many of the Muslims. So he killed him. And when he killed him, he went ahead and told Hind bint Utba that I have killed Hamza. So she set him free. Said, you are free now, liberate me. She set him free. You are liberated. And she went ahead to Hamza and she cut him. She had his liver. She had the liver of Hamza because she. She hated Hamza so much, she killed many of her relatives. But afterwards, she became Muslim, Hind. And her son is Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan. Muawiyah is her son. And her husband is Abu Sufyan. All of them, they became Muslim afterwards. Alhamdulillah. Yes. Yes. The slave, he came to the Prophet and the Prophet said, don't let me see you. The slave, he used an arrow, spear, to kill Hamza. He said, afterwards, by this spear I killed two people. He killed Hamza and he used this spear to kill also another person, disbeliever who used to prophesy. His name is Musaylama al-Kadhab in Yamama, here in Saudi Arabia, somewhere close to Riyadh. So Habashi killed Hamza with that sphere, and with the same sphere he killed another one, disbeliever, one who prophesied.
So he later became a Muslim, right?
Yes, he became a Muslim afterwards. And he was in Sham, Syria. Yes, the Muslim army is here. Paradise.
All of this mountain?
Yes. It's extensive. This is Jabal Uhud. Chain. Chain.
Huh?
It extends.
Yeah,
yeah, but so. See? It's extensive.
Where did Khalid al-Walid from this side come?
Khalid al-Walid came from here. Because the people here were killed.
Yeah.
He came from this area.